This statement of Rajashekara inspired us to make a trip to Holalagundi on the roads traveled by the kings, the chieftains, troops, traders and common people through ages, green with its memory. The dating of the murals of Hampi has always been a debate among researchers and academicians during the past decades. The Hampi ceiling murals have been compared and contrasted primarily with the Veerabhadra Swami temple murals in Lepakshi, Andhra Pradesh, which have been accepted by most scholars as late phase Vijayanagara. Hampi murals, on the other hand, have been categorized as middle phase Vijayanagara and dated as late 15th or early 16th century by several Indian scholars. Western scholars, including Anna Dalla Piccola, however, considered them as late 18th and 19th century paintings. Vijayanagara kings were great patrons of the art, architecture, music, dance and theatre. Architectural contribution of the Vijayanagara can be seen throughout South India. The art of painting as part of temple and palace buildings reached a remarkable status during the period. Though not much of visuals painted on perishable materials are available, there are enough specimens of wall and ceiling paintings on the temples built under the Vijayanagara patronage. Based on the existing examples, historians classify Vijayanagara paintings into three phases. The painting fragments found in the Sangeeta Mandapa of the Varadamana Swami temple in Tiruparuttukundram, built in 1387-88 AD, is considered to be of the early Vijayanagara phase. The middle and later phase of Vijayanagara paintings are still debated and research scholars suggest various hypotheses. The paintings in Lepakshi and Somapale are clubbed together considering their styles. The paintings from Patishwaram, Srirangam, some paintings in the Brihadeshwara temple can be compared with those at Somapale and Lepakshi. The large amount of well-preserved paintings is seen in Lepakshi. The paintings here are comparable with the sculpture details in the architecture and are contemporaneous to the structure. Interestingly, two narratives exclusively belonging to the Tamil territory are depicted in the temple. As a relief sculpture, we find the story of Siriyala Charitram profusely carved in a sequence of narrative panels. The story is of Paranjothi, an army general becoming a saint and daring to sacrifice his only son as an expression of his devotion towards Shiva. The other story is of Manuniti Chola, painted as a sequence of narrative on the ceiling of the Natya Mandapa. This story belongs to Tiruvarur, where the Chola king sentences his son to be run over by a chariot as a justice for the harm caused to a cow. For treating all living beings equal and being the custodian of justice, Shiva blesses the king. These two stories induce the researchers to explore the relationship of the temple with the Tamil region. The richness of the hues of the Vijayanagara artists is seen in the colors of Dashavatara panels in the ceiling of the Raghunatha shrine of the temple. Though most of the paintings are gone, we can see the vibrant forms of Narasimha, Matsya, Kurma, Vamana in bright colors. Veerabhadra, painted in the ceiling of the Mahamantapa, is one of the largest single character frescoes. This magnificent piece of art has suffered immensely due to the ravages of time and the lack of proper preservation. The panels depicting various narratives from the Puranas are seen in the various parts of the temple ceiling. The paintings are highly stylized and rendered with great mastery and embellished with intricate details. Chitrasutra of the Vishnudharmotar Purana, one of the earliest Indian treatises on paintings, specifies that the master praises the lines, critics the shading, women the ornamentation and common people the richness of color. O best of men, keeping in mind, effort should be made in such a way that there comes about captivation of the minds of everyone. In Lepakshi, the characters are displayed individually with minimal overlapping. Every character is rendered and differentiated by the body color, dress, drapery, and the ornaments. Women and men are shown made up according to their ranks. We are able to see through the wardrobes of the royal and the commoners of the Vijayanagara period through these paintings. Men are clothed mostly in dhotis tied as panche and with a uttariya. They have different hairdos like shika, jatamukuta, kirita or kulai and wear many ornaments. Women have braided their hair or made up their hair into dhamila, and the goddesses wear a kirita mukuta. The profusely delicate ornaments painted on the head, neck, ears, arms, limbs and the waist are remarkable. They reflect the fashion of that period. The art of mural painting has a long history in India. The popular sites of Ajanta, Bagh, Badami, Sitanavasal and Tanjavur are testimony to the expertise of the Indian artists. Though not much are available of the Hoysala murals, we do find traces of paints in the Hoysala temples. The illustrated Jaina Dhavala manuscripts stand proof for the continuation of painting tradition in that period. Apart from these specimens, the continuity of the visual tradition is vouched by the treatises on paintings like the Chitrasutra of Vishnu Dharmotar Purana, Samarangana Sutradhara and Manasolasa, written during the consecutive periods of history. With such a rich and continuous tradition of painting handed over from generations, with high traffic of trade and cultural exchanges and territorial expansions, it is quite natural for the Vijayanagara kingdom to inherit and share the painting tradition from their predecessors. One of the prominent visible feature that conveys the relationship of the Lepakshi, Somapale and the Vijayanagara murals of Tanjavur and Patiswaram with their immediate predecessors, the Hoysalas, is the unique depiction of the protruding eye. The Jaina manuscripts of the Dhavala and Kalpasutra belong to the Hoysala periods, show a similar treatment of the eye. In the Jain manuscripts, the full dimension of the eye on the other side is painted. However, in the Lepakshi images, we can notice that the other eye is painted only till the eyeball and the remaining part of the eye stays hidden. Among the themes painted in the Lepakshi Natyamantapa ceiling, we find the narratives of Draupadi Swayamvara, Kiratarjuniyam, Ramayana, Bukailasa, Girija Kalyana and the narrative of Manuniti Chola along with portrayal of Vatapatrasai and Veerabhadra worshipped by a group of noble men. While the specimens of paintings considered as the late phase of Vijayanagara resemble each other in style, the paintings of the Rangamandapa of the Hampi Virupaksha temple does not seem to match with these. Hampi paintings have a unique style somewhat different from these in terms of the relationship with the structure, details, rendering and also the layout, though the themes depicted are similar. The narrative of Lepakshi are seen painted across the ceiling with borders at the top and bottom. They have a continuous narrative. The paintings spread over a single frame bordered by beams. Contrarily, in Hampi, the visual plane is divided into various panels depicting different themes. Unlike the Lepakshi paintings, the figures in the Hampi murals portray individual characters or scenes and not a continuous narrative. The Virupaksha temple murals are painted in a layout comprising of registers of various dimension depicting the Trimurtis with their consorts, the Girija Kalyana, the Dikpalakas, narrative panels of Manmatha Vijaya and Tripurantaka, Dashavatara, Kama, Rati, Sita Swayamvara, Sita Kalyana, Draupadi Swayamvara, Gopika Vastrahaparana, and the procession leading to the Virupaksha temple. Circumscribing the ceiling are smaller beam paintings depicting various deities and activities. Decorative borders with floral motifs divide the register. The Trimurtis form the top row. In the middle are Shiva and Parvati, attended by Narada and Tumburu on either sides. Shiva and Parvati reside in Hampi as Virupaksha and Pampambika. Virupaksha is the ruling deity of the Pampakshetra. He is Shiva who comes to marry Pampambika or Parvati, honoring her penance on the banks of Manmathakonda. To the right of Shiva, we see Vishnu with Lakshmi on his lap. He is flanked by Garuda and Hanuman. To the left of Shiva are Brahma and Saraswati. They are flanked by two Dwarapalakas. The strokes and the color palette of the Hampi artists differ from that of the Lepakshi artists. The flexibility and grace portrayed in the Lepakshi paintings are substituted by a formal static pose in the Hampi paintings. Manmatha Vijaya. Manmatha Vijaya is the story of the victory of Shiva over Manmatha. This episode has close association with the sacred geography of Hampi. It is an integral part of the Stala Purana. It is also discussed in the 12th century poet Harihara's Girja Kalyana Mahaprabandham. Shiva performs penance after the death of his first wife Dakshayani. Dakshayani, reborn as Parvati, attends to Shiva while he was in yogic contemplation. Meanwhile, the gods need a son from Shiva to defeat the demon Tarakasura. Manmatha goes on the mission to unite Girija and Shiva and gets burnt by the wrath of Shiva. However, the mission is accomplished and the divine marriage happens. The panel shows Manmatha shooting his arrow at Shiva. Manmatha and Rati are on a chariot pulled by a parrot. He holds a bow made of sugarcane. Shiva is painted as a yogi. At the right bottom are Nandi, Parvati and Vasanta, the spring. The water body at the bottom is filled by a profusion of water creatures. The background is festooned with lively animals. Girija Kalyana. The portrayal of the Girija Kalyana scene has a great significance in the Virupaksha temple as it relates to the local myth, the marriage of Pampambika with Virupaksha, the presiding deities of the temple. A tank adjacent to the temple, popularly known as Manmathakunda, is believed to be the exact place where Shiva set ablaze Manmatha for meddling with his austerities. Circumscribed inside an ornate black border with floral motifs, the Girija Kalyana panel can be seen divided into three levels and five sub-panels. In the top level are painted images of Kinnaras, rishis viewing the wedding from their towers with architectural forms and foliage typical to the Hampi landscape, Purushamriga and Kamadenu. The central division shows Himavant giving Girija in marriage to Shiva under an iconic tree. A four-headed Brahma is standing in a separate arch behind Shiva, and behind him are Vishnu and Saraswati. To the right of Himavant are Parvati's mother Mena with another lady. Three more similarly attired crowned ladies are painted behind them. Bringi, Nandi and Ganesha are portrayed in the extreme right. In the extreme left are Veerabhadra with the divine musicians Tumburu and Narada. Beneath this register runs a horizontal band that portrays Nandi and numerous Ganas joyously playing musical instruments. The entire scene is a depiction of festivity and celebration. Great care has been taken to portray the local landscape and other particulars. The scene is a frozen moment of the Girija Kalyana narrative. it is wise to compare the same theme in Lepakshi to understand the distinction between both the styles. Girija Kalyana scene in Lepakshi, unlike the vertical and horizontal divisions in Hampi, is depicted in a single plane. The arrangement of the characters are in a line with minimum overlapping. The Girija Kalyana scene occupies almost 3/4 of the entire stretch of the narrative panel, with the Panigrahana event as the center of focus. The prime event of Shiva and Parvati marriage is depicted inside the enclosure. Shiva as Kalyana Sundara is shown as the biggest character in the center. Girija is of a smaller height. Her right hand is extended towards Shiva and the left hand holds a flower. Nandi is shown near Shiva's feet. Himavant and Meena are on the sides of Parvati. In an extended space of the mandapa, Brahma is seen seated performing the wedding rituals. Behind Brahma, the Ashtadikpalakas are shown standing in a row. To the left of the mandapa, we see three ladies standing in a gesture of hailing glory. Behind them are Vishnu and Sadashiva. Behind Sadashiva, we find an interesting depiction of eight characters with different hairdos. Significantly, the third figure among these has a parrot on the top of his head. The entire stretch is completed with borders on the top and bottom and made to look festive with tassels and festoons. The Girija Kalyana scene in Lepakshi is more ritualistic than the one in Hampi, which has a more of a sense of celebration and amusement. Whatever be the period of the Hampi murals, they are remarkably unique and make us think that there could have been various artist guilds working parallel on different styles during a same period of time. On the trail of tracking the trial of the murals of Virupaksha, we can compare them with some other examples. The tone and colors are akin to the murals we find in Sri Kurmam, Andhra Pradesh. The antiquity of art plays a vital role in educating us about the culture, political and social life of the period in which it was done. Religious or secular, the visual evidences of the past are some of the important tools to reconstruct history and understand the path we have traveled. In this context, the work of Rajasekara Sindhgi took our attention towards the paintings at Siddheshwara Temple in Holalagundi. After a long, exciting travel, what awaited us was a shocking disappointment. We landed in a temple brightly painted with fluorescent metallic hues, still hoping that the important segments of paintings would have been untouched inside. But that was not the case. The intricate panels described in the book were gone forever. Fluorescent colors had replaced them. The evidence that could give us a lead in the dating of the Hampi paintings are no more available. This is not the only case in the country. The paintings in the third prakara of the Audayar temple in Thiruparanthurai in Tamil Nadu, seen in 2002, was whitewashed and gone in 2006. Without any documentation. Professor Job Thomas had published the only evidence of the murals of Patiswaram which he had documented in the mid-1970s. They are sandblasted and gone now. The Vijayanagara paintings of the Tiruparuttakundram in Kanchipuram have undergone a process of repainting which has given it a different facelift altogether. Many such cases are reported in the newspapers every day. The need of the hour is awareness and proper documentation of the rich heritage of the past to pass it on to the future generation in case the original may be lost.